My name is Mohammed Guleid. I'm the CEO of the Frontier Counties Development Council, FCDC. This is an umbrella of 10 counties of the northern parts of Kenya, mostly the very arid part of the Republic of Kenya. We are here in Garissa to be gathered here for 3 days for a conference which is named the Pastoralist Leadership Summit. Now, the Pastoralist Leadership Summit is composed of governors, it's composed of members of parliament, it's composed of speakers of the county assembly, and county women reps. But in this conference, starting tomorrow morning, we have included in our conference this time members of the county assembly, who form part of the elected leadership of all the counties that form part of this coalition of counties and members of the Pastoralist Parliamentary Group. Therefore, the theme of this conference is fostering peace, security, and enhancing socio-economic development. The reason why we are coming here mainly is to discuss issues around that theme, and in particular, more importantly, we want to discuss issues that have to do with our economic development, uplifting our people, taking them out of poverty. This region has one of the highest poverty rates in the Republic of Kenya, one of the poorest indicators in terms of health, in terms of water services, in terms of education, in terms of all indicators of development. We have lagged behind for the last 50 years. Even though now we have seen devolution is beginning to show a slight increase in prosperity, but still we are far away, far away from reaching where we are supposed to be. Therefore, this conference is meant therefore to take a discussion, bring the leadership together, and this leadership comprising of the groups that I've just mentioned shall discuss three main thematic areas. One is peace and security. Peace is very important for this region, and in particular why we chose Garissa this time, more than any other place, is to send a message to the people of Kenya and to the whole world that Garissa is a safe county, is a county where you can do business, you can do your investment, and for that particular reason we have chosen Garissa to send that strong message. There is a perception out there that this area is not safe. We want to really make sure that thought is taken away from the people. The second thematic area where we're going to discuss is issues of education, socio-economic development, and other issues of that nature. These are also pertinent issues, and we are going to discuss them intensively and extensively through the various breakout sessions which we shall be undertaking, particularly on the second day. Finally, we are going to discuss major dialogue issues that are ongoing in the Republic of Kenya. The issue of the upcoming census, there's the issue of the referendum, there's the issue of the handshake. Therefore, tomorrow we shall have various dignitaries, and the event will be officially opened by His Excellency the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya, Honorable William Ruto, accompanied by cabinet secretaries and a number of ambassadors representing foreign countries and development partners who are very pertinent about supporting our region. After 3 days, we shall come with a resolution. Our resolution will be on what to do. For example, what are we going to do about peace and security? Where can we join hands to ensure that no one dies without any meaningful reason? Actually, nobody should die because of pasture or because of resources or because of imaginary lines called boundaries or because of ethnic violence or because of religious violence. All these things are barbaric, to say the truth. And we need to come up with resolutions that will find ways and the roadmap to bring fostering unity and peace and security within our people. And number two, we need to find a solution to issues of food security. Our area is one of the most food scarce areas, despite us having sufficient water, sufficient arable land, sufficient resources to sustain proper and adequate production of food in line with Agenda 4 of the national government. Another issue that we really want to come out with on resolution is to agree on what response we can give. For example, the Commission of Revenue Allocation, which decided to reduce county allocations to our region. We have not yet understood why they took that back, but this conference will come up with a counter narrative as to why we should actually get more funds instead of less. In fact,